Picture this. You go shopping and you find the perfect manufactured home that meets everything you want and it's only $40,000. That's very doable, right? You get excited, but wait, did you know about these costs that will come up that you have to spend to get your manufactured home installed and ready to go? Watch this video. I'm gonna tell you all about these, help you prevent making some big mistakes that could cost you money, and stay tuned to the end because I have two really big secrets that are gonna help you save a lot of money when it comes to building a manufactured home and a free checklist that will help you through the process. So when we speak about manufactured homes, you may hear it called one of these things, a mobile home, manufactured home, single wide, double wide, and now triple wides, or a trailer. So these are all names that have been used over the years. The HUD standard of building was enacted in 1976. So mobile homes that were made before them can be a little bit more difficult to get financing on, but it's still not impossible. Manufactured homes are actually one of the most cost-effective and fastest ways to build and get somebody out of renting, out of any kind of bad situation that they could be in. They typically come in 1 to 2 pieces depending on the size home that you're getting, and they're joined together on site. That sticker price that you see on the home, though, is not all that you'll pay. Here are some of these extra costs that you need to know and that need to be paid for before you can officially move into your manufactured home. The first is a permit. So this is made with the city or county that it's going to be built on. This is basically written authorization that's issued by the county or city. These ensure that the safety of the work is done and it's in compliance with building, construction, and zoning codes. Here in Carroll County, you have to have at least 4 acres for a manufactured home. But if you go over the line into Alabama, land is cheaper and they do not have the same restrictions with manufactured home like they do here in Georgia. Here in Carroll County, to get the permit, it will cost you around $650. Next, you're going to need a septic system. We don't need any of that. This includes having your percolation test, which will determine where the septic tank should go and make sure it's suitable. So if you want to find one that has sewer already on it, these are going to be closer to the cities, and this is really hard to find one that's close to the city and has the size acreage that you need to put your mobile home. You can find them, but those are just typically more difficult, so that's why we're saying you'll need to have a septic tank done. So getting a septic tank installed here is going to cost you around $5,500. Next, we got to have some running water. So if county water is available, you will want to have that set up as well as the plumbing ran to the inside of the manufactured home. This will run you around $2,700. Now, this price can vary because it depends on how rural your spot is. So if it's really far away and way down a back road, you may have some issues or some big costs associated with getting that water set up. And you also want to look at how close the most previous spot of water was ran, because that'll kind of give them an idea of how much it would cost to get yours set up. So those two can depend on this price, but that is something that will be done. Now, of course, if you find a spot that doesn't offer county water, you can also look into getting a well done, because that may be a cheaper alternative for you. Next, we want an HVAC system. So this is our heating and air system here. We obviously don't want to freeze to death, but here in Georgia, you're more likely going to sweat to death if you don't have the AC. So we want to get that done. Now, getting a brand new one, getting everything set up and ran will typically cost you about $6,200, but it will come with a warranty, so that'll have you set for several years. Next, and this is the most expensive one, is going to be your foundation work. You will see some manufactured homes, typically this is your older ones, that have that underpinning around the home, and it's just to keep you from seeing under it, but that is not a permanent foundation. And with most types of loans, you have to have a permanent foundation, and that is always the preferred type because that is permanent. This is typically done by concrete and blocks put around it just to make it set on top of it and be really stable. This is going to cost you about $10,000 to $12,000. So it's a really big expense, but it's really important, and make sure that you have a really good manufactured home. Also, we got to have some way to get in that front door. Unless you have granddaddy long legs over there and you can just jump up to make it in, we got to have some kind of method to get in. So most people want to put up some kind of front porch. Typically, they also want a back porch as well with a deck and some things like that. But this will cost you around $8,000. With how high lumber is, is, you never know. It is going down, so that's a good thing, but it could cost you in the $8,000 range. Also, most people want to have some nice landscaping done. When they bring in the manufactured home, it's going to tear up all of the grass and make it really nasty. So depending on what you get, this could run you between $1,000 and $1,500, depending on, you know, if you're getting sod, flowers, what you want to have done there. Now, once all of this is done, you will want to get a letter from a structural engineer saying the foundation is solid, and this is also required by most lenders. This is really important because you don't want to have a wobbly house or make sure that where those pieces were joined together that it is secure and it's good to go and will hold together. So this is going to run you anywhere from $375 to $500. Another thing you want to do is get a termite bond. So this is preferred to ensure everything is ready to go without any issues. You would hate to spend all this money and then later find out you have an infestation. So this will cost between $200 to $250. Now, of course, there are other costs that you might incur depending on what kind of land you end up putting your manufactured home on. If the land that you buy is really wooded, you're obviously going to have to clear out some kind of spot to put your home and have a yard, a driveway, any of that kind of stuff. So if you're doing that and you're going to hire someone, it's typically going for around $1,000 an acre right now. You also need a really nice level spot to place the manufactured home on. So if it's not flat, that is an expense that needs to be calculated into it. That will typically cost you around $200 an hour for someone to come in there. And a lot of these guys do have minimum requirements. You have to rent them out for so many hours to get it done. And then, like I said, you may want the driveway cut into the land. So that can be taken care of earlier. But if you want gravel or anything like that to make it more of a solid driveway, that's going to be another $650. That's for like a standard, you know, kind of small driveway. But again, depending on how deep into the property the home sits, that can obviously go up a lot. We look at all those costs, and let's say the land is absolutely ready to go and you just have to spend the cheapest of all those estimates I gave you, that is still going to bring your total up to $35,000. So if you're finding one for $40,000, that's almost the exact same price as the mobile home is just to get it set up. So now all these costs are not absolutely mandatory. If you're not financing the manufactured home, which means you have cash to pay, you could waive the structural engineer letter, but this is not a recommendation because this is what ensures that everything is stable and ready to go. If money is tight, you could also skip the deck and porch, skip the landscaping, and skip the termite bond. I have seen people get pretty creative. I've seen people use the concrete blocks to go up into their home instead of using the steps or the porch. And Home Depot has some of the cutout steps that are ready to go that you can use and build on to make your own cheap little steps just to get up into your home. So that's a cheap way to save some money and wait on that later. Landscaping, you can go and buy the grass seed yourself, plant it, plant some flowers, not have to pay for all of that expense. And then with termite bonds, I know of a few local companies that will come out and do a free termite letter. So they're checking, making sure there's no termites right then and can give you that okay, but it doesn't cover the warranty of the bond for later on. So those are a couple ways that you can definitely save some money, put the money towards other things and save those for later. As I promised, here are two big tips to save you major money when you're building your manufactured home. But first, if you guys have learned anything from this, I sure would appreciate if you would like and let me know just so I can know that this has been helpful. So the very first is to shop the loan. So many of your manufactured dealers charge an insane amount of interest when they are looking at financing the mobile home through them. So if you shop around, I always recommend doing three, then you can make sure you're getting the absolute best deal possible because most of these newer manufactured homes will qualify for most loans. So it's not as hard to get a loan as a lot of people might think. And I personally have seen much better rates when using an outside lender. And depending on the difference, this could save you tens of thousands of dollars in the long run. So it's a really big savings that you could really make a difference in how much you're paying for a mobile home. The second tip I have is to find some land that previously had a home or manufactured home or anything on it, because these are going to already have, hopefully, the septic, the water. They should already have the land cleared. It should already be flat and level with the driveway in place. So if you're taking those things out of the equation, that's instantly saving you money and going to knock off a bunch of these expenses that you would have to pay otherwise. Plus, sometimes they may already have a poured concrete pad or something else cool, an old deck that used to be there that, you know, you may need to take down, but you can still use some of the wood. Just a couple of those things to really save you some money. So what do you guys think? Are there any expenses that you have seen that I missed or maybe was cheaper or more expensive that you found out? I would love to know in the comments. Let me know. And as I promised, I have a free checklist for you that you'll want on hand when you're looking at the different options of where to put your manufactured home. So go grab it in the comments and that'll help you make that decision. As always, I'm your unicorn real estate agent helping you turn your home dreams into a reality.